The first thing you're going to do is to navigate to the sfml-dev.org. We're going to click on download, whatever the latest version is at the time of you watching this video. And we're going to go ahead and catch that 64-bit on Visual C++ 2017. Once that's downloaded, we are going to open up the folder. You're going to copy all of the files, and what I usually recommend then is that you're going to go to your local disk. I like to make a folder named SFML, and then within that folder, I like to make a folder with the version of SFML that we're installing. This is interesting if you're going to have several projects and there might be some breaking changes in newer updates. So we're going to paste in the files right here. Okay, now that this is done, we can go ahead and create a project. I will be using Visual Studio 2022. We are going to create a new project of the sort empty project. Next, I'll just call it SFML tutorial. Create. Now that we have our project set up, we can right-click on source files, add new item. We are going to be adding a CPP file. All right, now that this is done, we are going to go to the project settings, properties. Be sure to select all configurations. We'll first go to general and look for additional include directories. Press edit. And let's navigate over to where we downloaded SFML. And we're going to take the include file, just press once, and then select folder. And then OK. We are then going to go to linker, general, and we're going to go to additional library directories. Press edit, double click, three dots, navigate back to the SFML folder, and take the lib, press once only, and select the folder. Then OK. And lastly, we are going to enter a couple lines here. We're going to enter sfml-system.lib. Actually, add the -d, sfml-window-d.lib and sfml-graphics-d.lib. Press OK and apply. And then what we're going to do lastly is go to release and re-edit this and remove the -d on all of them. This way we'll have debug for debug and the release version for the release version. Okay, now that that's set up, let's write a quick code to test if this works. Okay, now that this is done, we can save the file and try to run it. And you'll see that we'll get a small error and this is normal. And you'll see that we're missing some DLL files. So what we're going to do now is we are going to right-click on the project folder, and we're going to do open folder in file explorer. You're going to go one level up, go to x64 debug, and just to find your application executable. You're then going to navigate back to where you installed SFML, click into bin, and copy all these DLL files. Just copy them, Control C and Control V within this folder. And now, if we go back and try to run it, there we go. You have successfully installed SFML and it all works. Okay, this is it for this tutorial. Thank you very much for watching. If you liked the video, leave a like and comment in the description and subscribe, of course. And also, I posted a similar video on how to install SFML on Linux. So if you want to go and watch that and see how much faster it is, I would really love if you do that. And that's it for me today. Have a nice day and good luck with your future endeavors. Bye-bye.